Okay, I've got a sample COBOL program, so let's just deconstruct it. This program could have been printed originally on punched cards, right? So 80 columns. The first six columns are the sequence number. So that shows where the line is in the program, right? From 10 to whatever is the highest number, right? And it goes up by tens, 10, 20, 30, 40, right? The reason is that way you can insert additional lines in between. Like you can see between 40 and 50, someone has inserted lines 41, 42 to 46, right? And the reason why cards had sequence numbers was in case you dropped it on the floor and the cards got out of order, and then you could put them back into order. There was also a machine called the card sorter that would automatically sort cards into sequential order according to the column number. Okay, so first line is the identification division. There are four divisions in a COBOL program. There's the identification division. There's the environment division, there's the data division, and there's the procedure division, which you can't see because it's down at the bottom. Procedure division is where the actual executable lines are. Then there's the program ID, right? And so the name of this program is sample. Everything ends with a period, right? And there's the name of the author, right? The date written, right? Then there's the comments. Comments have an asterisk in column 7. Comments are the only type of line that uses anything in column 7, right? There are also blank spaces in between, which is nice. Then you have your environment division, input-output section, file control. This is where you define your files, your input and output files, right? So there's one input file. Sysin was the standard name of an input device on an IBM mainframe. So the name of the file is student file. I think 16 was the maximum number of characters for the name here, but the actual external name is limited to 8 characters, right? Organization is line sequential. It means that it's a sequential file, right? That you read line by line. And the output print file, sysout. Sysout is your standard output device, right, which is normally the printer on the mainframe. So the name is print file here, right? Again, line sequential, meaning you sequentially print the lines, right? Then use your data division, your file section. File section is what defines your files, as opposed to the working storage section, which defines the variables that you use only internally in this COBOL program, right? So there's an FD, which is a file definition, right? It shows the name of the program, how many characters are in the record, right? And what the name of the record is, right? The record is student in, right? So it's defined as an 01 level pick X43, which 43 there matches a 43 there. Some people used to do like a breakdown of 05 levels in here, but the more recommended way is to just define 101 level, right? Then the output file, FD print file, right? Record contains 80 characters. Data record is this, right? Which is 80 characters. Okay, so it's going to be an 80 character report printed on 80 character paper, right? If it was a tape file, FD, then it might have a blocking factor. For example, a tape would write maybe like records where each record was 100 characters, and then there are 10 records in a block. So then here it would say record contains 100 characters, block contains 10 records, right? The reason why it did that is it was easier, more efficient for a tape drive to write records in a block as opposed to writing one record at a time. It would write records in, say, like a block of 10. There was an optimum number for a tape drive, so I forget what it is, right? But then it would leave a gap, and then it would leave another, write another block, and then it would leave a gap, and then it would write another block. So you get the idea. As a consequence of that, when you were writing records to a tape drive, like say if you wrote seven records, it wouldn't actually physically write them. It would wait until it got to the blocking factor. It would wait until it got to 10 records, and then it would write the whole block out. That way it minimizes the I/O operations. Here's your working storage section where you define your working storage fields. A lot of people didn't define any 77 levels. They just defined everything as an 01 level, right? So that's what this author is doing. Data remains switch, pick X to value spaces, right? And records written, pick 99, so it's a two-digit field, and it's not initialized, right? Actually should be initialized. It should say value 0 there. Detail line, right? That's what you're writing out on your report, on the detail line, right? So there's two fillers of spaces, right? And then there's the record image, right, which is not initialized, right, because it's going to come from the input file, right? Then summary line is probably like a total that is written at the end of the report. So again, you have your filler spaces. You could say either spaces or space. It didn't make any difference, right? Total read is a two-digit number, right? If there was any possibility that you would read more than 99 records, you should make it a three-digit number. Filler, pick X17, value records were read, right? So a filler didn't have to be spaces. It could be some fixed string, right? But it had to be fixed because you cannot move something to filler. Filler is not a true variable name. It's just a dummy name that cannot be used in the procedure division, right? Records were read, okay? So that's pretty clear. This is the first page, right? So I'll continue with the next page in the next video, and thanks for watching.